Hello and welcome. In this video series of Azure Functions, today we are going to learn how we can deploy Azure Functions from VS Code. In the previous video, we learned how we can write Azure Functions in VS Code. If you are new to the channel, I will put link to that video in the description box. To deploy your first Azure Function from VS Code, let's open VS Code. So this is a function that we have created in the last session. So to deploy a function from VS Code, first of all, we need to sign into the portal from here. So click on this sign into Azure button. It will open a browser window for us. Enter your credentials and click on sign in. Once you have successfully signed into the portal, close the browser window. We are successfully signed into the portal. So these are the subscriptions that are listed under my account. Now to deploy the function, go to the workspace, click on this deploy button, and we have to deploy a function app. Click on this deploy to function app. So choose the subscription under which you have created that function app. I have created the function app under this subscription. So it will list down all the function apps that have been created under this subscription. Let's wait. So this is a YouTube demo app that we created in the last session. Are you sure you want to deploy to YouTube demo? This will override any previous deployments that can't be undone. So if you have already deployed to this function app, then this is a warning message that will be given. Since we are deploying first time, let's say okay. Deployment is in progress. We can check it in output window. Deployment is successful. Syncing triggers. Querying triggers. These are the list of tasks that will be done by deploying to Azure Functions app. So this is the link to our function app, YouTube demo app .azurewebsites.net/api/getname. So this get name comes from here, from our function app. So let's copy this URL or follow and check whether it's working fine or not. Control C, the browser, click on this. So this is working fine. This HTTP trigger function executed successfully. Pass a name in the query string or in the request body for personalized response. So let me show you where from this message is coming. So this is the message that we are seeing in the web browser. So this is one more message that might come, that will come if we pass the name in the query string. So let's check this one. Hello, code by this HTTP trigger function executed successfully. So this is the message hello name part this HTTP trigger function executed successfully. So if you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more. Thanks.